Hello, hello. So what do we got going on today? We really do need to figure out how to get this migration stuff done. We go to repositories, dev, quirk, API. We'll see here that we've got this like husk that remains from us moving the API. And the goal here is that we basically want to make this be entirely its own thing with its own Docker file and everything. And then we're going to run migrations inside of that in the cloud, in pipelines, basically. We kind of need to just get a local version. And I'm going to go to GitLab. We need this, this, and those four layers essentially make up what we need to build this thing. Now, so that's going to be kind of the goal, is reconstruct this Docker file from its current situation. Okay, so what I need to do now is I'm going to go back to this quirk repository here, and here's our API. And so again, we're going to open up this Docker file, and we are basically going to work on reconstructing this thing. Let's keep moving. So first and foremost, I'm just going to get rid of all of this because I'm not using that registry anymore. We'll have yarn install. We're going to need GraphQL for sure. I'm trying to get better at my jumps. Okay, so package.json is going to need to be copied. We'll do a yarn install production, and then this will be service. We've got our build command. We've got clean, and then we've got like a bunch of stuff here. Man, there's a lot of stuff that needs to be done here. Let me think about this. So the package.json is good, and the shared package.json, we don't need to worry about. We need to be able to run yarn workspace API GraphQL. Chat, let me explain to you kind of what I'm thinking. But here's what I'm thinking, chat. Right now, this command here technically needs to be ran in every repository. This is, if we go and we look at it, you're going to see GraphQL cogen, cogen YAML. It gets documents from GraphQL. And then we generate a GraphQL.ts and an SDK.GraphQL.ts. But then if you look here, you're going to see it says schema, packages, API, source, GraphQL, schema.GraphQL. This whole thing, because we're splitting all of the repos individually into their own service repos now. And so with that, if we go back into GraphQL, again, you're going to see that this is referencing something in the API. So we need to move, like we have a dependency here where all of this code gen, basically everything from really needs to be with the API. And say in this API image, if I run it, what can happen is that could actually get ran in here like this. Here's my cron image. All I'm going to do is I'm going to tell my cron image essentially, hey, download the API image and do a Docker CP of the GraphQL cogen that essentially gets rendered. And I think that might be what we're going to do. So, okay. So we know that we need the GraphQL documents full files, and we need this GraphQL schema file. So yeah, so that's the GraphQL command that we need to run first. And that GraphQL command will generate this schema file. Let's go ahead and remove these node modules. Boop, there we go. Okay. So we got that pushed. Let's go ahead and create our feature branch. All right, there's our feature migrate. So now I should be able to do checkout dash B, boom. Okay, so we're slowly at least getting to what I want to call is like the initial migration commit, get changed. So let's diff it. And yeah, you can see it's removing a bunch of the files that were basically removed from the package.json. So that's cool, that's good, that's what we want. And let's go to package.json, we'll go to 17, we'll just do that. So now let's do a yarn. And let's see what happens. And then I can do get checkout dash B feature and get stash repo repository. And then we push. And so now that's going to push up to Azure DevOps. I can go in here. I can create a new pull request. And in a few moments, we should see our Terraform start running in its own build pipeline. All right, cool. So there it is. So let's take a look. Let's see if it ran. It looks like it ran successfully. We got the green light. Yep. Terraform is telling us we got the green light as well. You can see here now in Terraform, and I just say confirm. And now it's actually going to apply those changes for me until I confirmed it, basically. And now that I've confirmed it, we're good to go. So we need Koa. I'm finagling node modules right now. Repos. So right now what we're doing is I'm trying to get this service repo somewhat demonstrable so that I can build an artifact out of it. I'm missing Koa, Sentry integrations, like all these other things. Okay, so really, really fast, looking at the high level, basically I have at the very beginning, you guys, the client. What you guys access is you guys access Cloudflare. This is only where I say you're allowed to talk to me. In other circumstances, this is not the case. But you're also going to see inside of this server a swarm workloads section. And this is all Quirk stuff. Everything you see here essentially is one container running on this host as well as these guys. So this is essentially all of Quirk at the moment. And we're migrating each one of these services to the cloud. So let's get back into it. Ta-da. So let's go to here. We need to take this all the way to here. We're going to do %s http://. Okay, so I yanked that, paste that in. User's fine. That's fine. That's fine. Discord.js. Okay, so it is trying to get Discord.js. I wonder if this will work with an NPM install. Discord.js form data. I'm going to do nvim, and I'm just going to go through these files like this. Cannot determine the executable to run. So we need del. That's the first thing we're going to need. I'm going to mv yarn.lock-new to yarn.lock. See, and that worked. Now if I go here and I refresh, yep. So what do we need? What do we need? Sentry node. We need Sentry node. We need IO Redis. Let's go ahead and start importing these. TMI.js, and then grab this and do this as well. I think that's everything. So now what I want to do is I'm just going to rm-rf all my yarn.locks. We know that we need to cp the original yarn.lock and basically move it here. What are we changing here? So this isn't bad. That's going to be interesting. That's going to be interesting. Okay, let's just do it. We don't need no stinking backups. I'm going to regret saying that. Yeah, no, literally famous last words. Let's do nvm use 14. Git source. I need this npmrc, by the way. Like, I need this npmrc. Is that the problem, that it needs to be under this organization scoped feeds? There, I'm literally just going to copy it exactly the way that they've got it. And then npm install. Yeah, it's just, it like does not want to find the newest version. It just, this doesn't make sense. This is very perplexing. All right, so I'm going to investigate this offline. When we come back, I will give you guys an answer on this. And again, it's not like the worst of news. It's fine. We're moving forward with the migration. And honestly, I'm excited about solving this problem because I do want to use this the way I want to use it. That's part of like this whole experience of like learning and stuff. Listen, guys, thank you guys again so much for hanging out with me today. I really, really appreciate it. Enjoy the rest of your day. Peace out, guys.